So I've been using AI mainly with ChatGPT to make some really cool designs, t-shirt designs, in the last 6 months. And here's an example of what I made in June. Take a look at these. And a lot of people have been asking me for the prompts of these, and they're really simple, and I wanted to share with you. I can't share with you all of them, that would take a really long. So I took the eight best ones that I thought were the best ones in June, and I'm gonna show you the prompts that I used and the prompts that ChatGPT came up with, and hopefully you can use it on different AI platforms, whatever you use. I think you could use these prompts in Midjourney or Leonardo or Ideogram or whatever one. You can try these out for yourself and see if it comes up with a really cool graphic like the ones I came up with. It probably won't be exactly the same ones, at least I hope not. It should give you something different and give you something really cool. So let's get into ChatGPT right now and I'll show you these prompts. So the first prompt I want to share with you is the mustard prompt. This is what the graphic and the t-shirt ended up looking like. And here on ChatGPT, I'm using StickerWiz. This is the short prompt that I wrote. So how about a mustard bottle fighting a ketchup bottle? That's all I wrote, a mustard bottle fighting a ketchup bottle. But this is what ChatGPT wrote. If I go in here, a cartoon mustard bottle fighting a cartoon ketchup bottle. Both bottles have arms and legs and they are in a dynamic fighting pose, which is really cool. The scene has a solid white background, a strong black border surrounding the white die-cut border, and no shadow. The mustard bottle looks like the plastic mustard bottle from the store, and the ketchup bottle looks like a classic plastic ketchup bottle. Both have intense expressions and are engaged in a playful, cartoonish battle. I didn't even say anime, but it has that feel of anime. And one of the things I did, you can see the hands cut off here and the hands cut off here in the design, was I put it in a rectangle so that it looks like it was in a frame. So that's one way you can do it. A lot of times ChatGPT cuts off the ends and I just want them to zoom back out so the whole thing is shown in, but you know, gotta work with what you got. So this one was really cool. I really like the design of this and I use some design in the back to help out with it, but I think it came out really cool. Doesn't necessarily look like the Heinz ketchup bottle. But this one does look like a mustard bottle that you would find in a restaurant or something. So I think it came out great. So the next prompt I believe was for RPG. This is the graphic and here's what the design ended up looking like. I think it came out really cool. And my prompt was even shorter than the last one. I just put a knight fighting a dragon. That's it. Super easy. This is why I love ChatGPT, by the way, because you can type in something like that and it just knows. White background, this is StickerWiz, it needs to look like a sticker, and it came out great. So here's what ChatGPT wrote though. A knight fighting a dragon in a cute cartoon style, die-cut sticker, right, because it's StickerWiz, digital drawing. The sticker has a solid white background, a strong black border surrounding the white die-cut border, and no shadow. And so this part, this ending part, you'll probably see a lot in the ChatGPT prompts because this is StickerWiz and that's kind of what it does. It has a sticker with a solid white background, which I like because then I can knock out the white background. And black border, you can see right here, which is nice too because then I can, you know, that's a nice edge that will be there surrounding the white die-cut border too. And no shadow because then it's nicer. Well, I mean, there's a shadow here, but not a shadow on there. So that easy to remove with your eraser tool in Photopea or Photoshop or Affinity Photo or whatever. So pretty cool style right here. I like how stylized it is with kind of the, it's not just flat, it has some gradient, not gradient, but light shadows and lights and stuff, highlights and shadows. So really cool. Okay, so the next prompt was for dragon. And here's the original graphic and the t-shirt design that I made with it. And I liked it because it was a dragon, a cute dragon reading a book and, you know, kind of a mashup of dragon and books. And I think that can do really well. Fantasy books too. Whoever likes to read fantasy books would be really cool. I wrote a kind of a long one here. So this is mine. I wrote a big cartoonish medieval style dragon with reading glasses, reading a book while sitting on a pile of books. The dragon is red and has a medieval style to him with big wing. I was supposed to call it wings, but I think it figured it out. And horns, die-cut sticker, digital drawing. The sticker has a solid white background, a strong black border surrounding the white die-cut border, and no shadow. I think what happened was I copied this from another one. I bet Let me go up here and see. Yeah, it was this one. I copied from this one and I didn't like how this turned out, so I kind of modified what it said. So let's see what ChatGPT actually wrote. And here it is. A big cartoonish medieval style dragon with reading glasses, reading a book while sitting on a pile of books. Very similar to what I said. The dragon is red and has a medieval style with big wings and horns. Die cut sticker, digital drawing. The sticker has a solid white background and a strong black border surrounding the white die cut border and no shadow. So it basically copied what I wrote. That's why it's so long, because I copied the prompt for the other one and kind of had it try again. And it came out really cool. It's got this tongue here, and I just love the style, cartoonish style of it. This is why I keep using ChatGPT, because it does some cool stuff. It's kind of weird with the books here, I think, but it came out great. And you can see some other dragon ones that I did with ChatGPT, some really cool ones that would make great stickers. But yeah, this is it's a good one. Try this out. I think books and dragons just is a good mashup. So hopefully you come out with something really good with this prompt, using your AI of choice, of course. So the next prompt was for the topic tattoo, and here's the original design and my t-shirt design that I made with it. And you can see this is it. It was the last one that I did. And basically I was trying to make all these other tattoos, and I liked this one, but then I added to it. So it's taking off of that one, and I just wrote, "Can you do one like this," which means that one, "with a flower banner on it that says coffee first?" And it didn't actually do that part, but it came out pretty cool. So, and I eventually put my own banner on it like I wanted. But this was the prompt. So we can see how long this one is. It says, "A colorful artwork of a to-go cup with a heart and flowers in a cool tattoo style, illustrated as a die-cut sticker. The coffee cup is detailed with vibrant patterns and surrounded by traditional tattoo style flowers and leaves. A heart is prominently displayed on the coffee cup, adding a touch of warmth and love. A flowing banner wraps around the cup with the phrase coffee first," which it never actually did, "in a classic tattoo font. The design is bold and eye-catching, blending classic and modern tattoo elements." Yeah. "The sticker has a solid white background, a strong black border surrounding the white die-cut border, and no shadow." So that same part right here, this ending one, is for every sticker with sticker. And I think it came out great. I love the tattoo style. I actually want to do more tattoo style stuff. And I think if you put this in some other AI, I think you may get some really cool results. I love the colorful tattoo style. And you might see some of these up here. I just did some of them. And some of these tattoo styles are really cool. I like this one, loose lips, sink ships. That alone could be a design right there. But yeah, tattoo style, surprisingly cool. So the next prompt was for 4th of July, I think. And here's the graphic, and here's the design I made with the graphic. And this is what I came up with, but you'll see that this one just says, "Remove the banner and words American Eagle," because I was talking about, and you can see some hot dogs here. If we go all the way up, this one. So I actually, and then as you can see, this one says, "Can you make it look more American?" Because I did this one. So the original one was an American eagle wearing sunglasses and its wings out and holding a hot dog, right? But then I said, "Make it look more American." And then I said, "Remove the American eagle," which is down here, and you can see it did it that way. And I believe if we click on it, yeah, it does it right here. So this is the prompt, the full prompt from ChatGPT. "An American eagle wearing sunglasses with its wings out, holding a hot dog in its claws. The eagle has an American flag pattern on its wings, and there are fireworks in the background. The sticker has a solid white background, a strong black border surrounding the white die-cut border, and no shadow." Think sticker whiz. "Remove the banner and the words American Eagle." It added that just to the end of it, and it did it. So pretty cool. I did it with this right here, the select tool, and I just selected over it and typed in "remove it," and it did it. Pretty cool. So this next prompt was for the topic pirate, and this was the graphic and the t-shirt that I came up with. I pretty much used the graphic with some text. And here's the graphic from ChatGPT. And you can see I said, "Switch out the skull for a cute skull of a cat with an eye patch," which I had this first. which I had this first. So I skull wearing a pirate hat with two swords, blah, blah, blah. And then I said, make it look more realistic, and I didn't like it. So then I said, switch it out for the cat, right? So let's see what ChatGPT wrote. A die-cut sticker of a cute cat skull wearing a pirate hat with an eye patch and jewelry. Two pirate swords cross each other below the cat, and the sticker has a solid white background, a strong black border surrounding the white die-cut border, and no shadow. And you'll notice, I think this was one of them that I traced in Affinity Designer so I could take out some of these things and move the swords around and kind of tilt it in a little bit different way. And that's what I like about ChatGPT. Sometimes you can just trace over it, and it's made with really simple lines and easy to draw over it and trace over it in Affinity Designer or Illustrator or anything with a pen tool. I believe this next prompt was for Japan. So here's the graphic and the t-shirt design that I came up with. I had so much fun with this design. A lot of people asked me about this one for the prompt. And you can see for me, when I wrote it, it was really easy. So this says a giant kaiju cat destroying a Japanese city with a big red circle behind it. That's all I wrote. And it came up with this, which is really cool. It's a really cool illustration. Now the full prompt from ChatGPT is this, not much different. A giant kaiju cat destroying a Japanese city with a big red circle behind it. That's what I wrote. Die cut sticker, digital drawing. The sticker has a solid white background, a strong black border surrounding the white die cut border, and no shadow. So really simple, and ChatGPT and StickerWiz knew to make it look like this. I just love this style. This is kind of their default style, unless you tell them otherwise. It has kind of this cartoonish look to it. Came out great. I think I removed this and added some other elements, but I love that. And I think it's really cool. Even if it doesn't sell, I think this is just a really cool artwork. Okay, lastly, this was for Boba, this prompt, and here's the design and the t-shirt design that came out with it. And you can see right here, my prompt was really easy, yes, but I like the rainbow hair from before, which means it came off of this one. No, I don't want him holding teas, I want him to be passed out. So it took me a while to do this. So this is the first one, a fat unicorn laying on his back, too many Bobas, and then I didn't want him doing like a sit-up. I wanted him laying down, and then it did it, but it took away the colorful hair, so I asked it to do with rainbow hair, and it did it. I like this one. So kind of a cute kawaii style, and let's see what it says. So it says, a big fat unicorn laying on his back with his head all the way back, looking defeated and passed out after drinking too many boba teas. With two boba teas next to him, the unicorn has rainbow hair, die-cut sticker, digital drawing. The sticker has a solid white background, a strong black border surrounding the white die-cut border, and no shadow. So if you ever want stickers, this is the phrase to put in there, for at least for ChatGPT. It makes it like that and made it really easy. Nice white border that looks like a sticker that you can cut out. And you know, this could be a sticker too on Redbubble if you're selling stickers. I think this would make a really funny sticker by itself. But I added it to a t-shirt design with some words here, and I think it came out great. It's a really cool one. I think it's one that a lot of people ask, because it's just like, how do you come up with this kind of creative stuff? Well, I came up with the words, but it drew it, and it looks really, really cool. Makes me laugh every time I see it. So there you go. Those are 8 different prompts that you can use on different AI stuff. Hopefully these help you kind of write your own as well, and kind of think creatively and making cool designs. I'd be curious to know how they turn out. Let me know in the comments. If you want to see some other styles that you can do with AI, I have this video right here that I talked about 10 different styles, not just kawaii, not just anime, but there's some other ones in there that are really cool. Check that one out if you haven't already. Thanks again for watching. And as always, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.